Folks, ScrambledO checking in. Let me try that again. Folks, ScrambledO checking in. What's up, guys? Quick video for you guys tonight. Out here in the woods doing some night carving. Last time I came out, I carved a cutting board. I roughed out my cutting board with my little Coleman lantern, and it worked out good enough. The video quality is not amazing, but it'll do. So what I'm doing today is carving at my new carving camp. I wanted to make another campsite that I could come to, just put up a tarp, do some carving, just to mix it up a little bit. I don't know what's gotten into me recently, but I've just had the itch to do some carving. Buddy Doug Outside's doing the carving and coffee right now, which is super cool. Of course, you guys know Doug Outside is much better than I am at carving. So this is just simple night out. Have a fire, made a little cup of coffee, and doing a little carving. And tonight I'm carving my camp kitchen spoon. This will be the spoon that I use when I go down to the base camp. The reason I'm redoing the spoon is because I believe cedar, which is what I do a lot of carving with, is not good to eat off. It's got something in it. Makes it bad for your health to eat with. I've had several people tell me that, and I don't know the scientific words, but there's something in there, and it ain't good for you. So I'm carving this one out of a dry, dead piece of black cherry. Beautiful grain. Wait till I sand this. You'll love how this spoon looks. It's gonna be sweet. You see, now I'm at this point with the spoon. Look at the grain, boy. Look at the contrast. This point, so here's the bowl of the spoon. This area from like here, sloping down, just takes so much time. I don't know, it's no easy, you can't hold the spoon, there's nowhere to grip. It's just a really hard area to work. That's what takes up most of my time doing these spoon carvings.
Just put the thumb right here on the back and just do like a quick little push. And I'm removing some good material. It just doesn't really go with the contour of the spoon, you know? The spoon should slope down and these cuts are like little chunks. Gives it a cool design, but I usually sand my spoons anyways, so. This knife I got from a buddy, it's the Chris Griffith Puco.
Man, I'm really loving this knife. I didn't
know that I'd like this so much. Love this little blade. What I learned earlier today is that the carving is to remove big pieces of material, obviously. But the finishing work, you can do with the spine of your knife and with sanding, sandpaper. You can really make an average carving look phenomenal if you just sand it and do a good job sanding. So that's what I'm gonna take away from this, is that let's not jump to conclusions
based on my carving job.
Let's wait and see how well it sands.
I think my lantern gotta get moved too. So right before the rain hit, I could hear the thunder, so I went and piled the firewood up pretty tall. So hopefully it stays burning. Nowhere really to put it. I'm supposed to hang it, and I don't have like a base platform for it. so it doesn't want to stand up straight. I'm almost done. Woo! That's cold! I'm almost done with the spoon anyways. Fire's barely hanging on. It's coming down pretty hard. It's actually pretty sweet carving. But this big bright light right here is my only source of light, because you can see the contours on the spoon on the, where you shave. And you can see the lines from where your previous cut was, and it makes it super easy. Not that this spoon's gonna look good, I just mean I feel good. Feel good doing it. Rain's starting to die down. It's been going for about 20 minutes. The fire's still going. I don't know how, but it's still going. I'll give you guys a spoon update. Little bitty spoon ball. Obviously it's not gonna be this long, but I like a long spoon when I'm doing the shaping because it gives you more material to hold on to. So I'm gonna keep the handle on this one thick because this is gonna be in my pack a lot and I don't want it super brittle. So I'm gonna thin out this handle a little bit, but not too much, because this is gonna be the spoon I use and eat with. So I want it to be able to weather the storm, so to speak. Get it? Get off me. I'm gonna just take the back of the blade and kind of rub it around and smooth out all them lines. That's such a helpful trick. It's like the step before sandpaper. All right, so here it is. All right, so here it is. I know the lighting's not very good. All right, there's the spoon before I sand it. Now I'm gonna put some sandpaper on it, give it a good rub down. That should make it look professional. All right, guys, sanding phase complete. Last step, time to put a little coat of oil on this and show it off. All right, boys, you ready to see it? Take a look. Here it is, boys. Finished product. Looks pretty cool when you sand it down. Tools of choice today, Chris Griffith Buko. A simple Mora spoon knife. This little teeny flex cut knife for the finer details. And a good old fashioned Granfors small forest axe. All right guys, that does it for me today. Carving in a thunderspoon. Carving in a thunderstorm. Carved this nice looking spoon, and this is gonna be my primary spoon I use for camp cooking meals down at the base camp. I appreciate you guys watching. Hope you enjoyed. And until next time, ScrambledO signing off.